I'm here again working on my W123. Today we're going to be checking out something that's been eating at me for a while. That's the timing chain stretch. Now one of my viewers pointed out that my engine has some kind of a badge or a label that indicates it was factory rebuilt by Mercedes. So in theory, this engine has been replaced at some point with a remanufactured engine. So the 220-ish thousand miles that are on the car's odometer may not be what's on the engine. But knowing the history of the engine, with it having a turbo drain leak, getting run low on oil, and starting to wear down the camshaft lobes, I'd kind of like to check this. It's been bugging me for a long time, and today's the day. We're going to pull this thing apart and check how much my timing chain has stretched. If need be, we're going to replace it. So there's two different methods to check the timing chain stretch. There's one known as the 2mm lift method, which is the most accurate, the best method that you could possibly do. It gives you a very exact result on timing chain stretch. The other method is lining up the camshaft timing mark, which is quick, easy, but not always accurate. We're going to try that one first because it's quick and easy, and it will give us an idea of where our timing chain is. And since I had to change the camshaft on this, if maybe I put in the offset keyway in the wrong direction. So let's hop into the engine bay and see what we need to do to get the valve cover off so that we can check this out. So the obvious things in order to remove the valve cover is there are four bolts that hold it on, then the linkage, Bowden cable, breather, and some of the throttle linkage stuff is in the way. So possibly return lines, but I think we can squeeze the injector return lines over out of the way. So I'm going to start by popping a bunch of this linkage loose. Now we can leave a lot of this attached, but we do need to disconnect it at the firewall and at the injector pump and at the cruise actuator at the least. We may find more here in a minute. So basically these ball and sockets just kind of pop off, and we'll lubricate these when we put them back on. But pop these off, so that's those two off. And then back here we've got a little clip. And then this should push forward out of our firewall bracket. And that way everything is loose. You know what might be a good idea is just take this whole piece off. So there's a clip on the front of that. Little spring clip. And then this ball and socket. Then our firewall piece can just completely come out. And that way that's out of the way. We're not dealing with it being stuck under injector lines. So I think at this point, all of this linkage is isolated to the valve cover. Nothing is attached anywhere else. So we can just leave this all here. We are going to have to disconnect our Bowden cable, which is another ball and socket, then a little push squeeze clip here. We can just squeeze that back out of there, set it off to the side. Now, I do believe we're going to pull this, which we can just pull off right there. And that's good enough. Then our four bolts, which I do believe are 13mm. Yep. So we'll put a 13 on here. In the way. Let's pop the air cleaner lid off. 10, 4 clips. Air air cleaner lid is loose. Now, there we have it. Our valve cover removed. So we're going to set this off to the side. While we're in here, we want to inspect everything. So look at our cam lobes. The state of everything in our engine bay. It's nice and smooth. Don't have any ledges or weird sharp spots. Do believe when I got the car, one of these lobes on cylinder 2 was the one that was not so happy with itself. So let me get you over here where you can see the timing marks so that we can line up our chain and check and see if we're in time. See right here, see that little line that's on the cam tower? There's a V mark on the back of the camshaft here that we can line up with that. Okay, so you can see the little V right up here, and we are going to very slowly and carefully turn this until those are lined up. Okay, so let me get you a little bit different angle. They look pretty closely lined up on camera, and they are just about as dead on as you're gonna get. So now with those marks lined up there, we should be able to look down at our crankshaft down in the front of the motor and see if we are lined up on our timing indicator down there. So bring the camera around and we'll take a look down in there. If we look down in here, in the front of the engine, down in between the radiator, see down in here, see our indicator right here, and see our 10 degree mark, 5 degree mark, and our 0 degree mark. It looks like we're right in between the 0 and the 5, which means there's in the realm of 2 to 2.5 degrees of wear. So let's pull the camera back out and discuss that. Okay, so with that kind of result, they were only a couple degrees off. To me, that indicates that that's within spec. These chains are designed to wear in, from what I understand, 2 degrees after 50,000 miles. So we've got just barely over 2 degrees. Now, there was an offset key in this, so that could be compensating for a couple more degrees of wear. But even then, we're at maybe 5 degrees of total chain elongation, which really isn't that bad in my mind. So I may hold off rolling in a new chain until we've put a few 100,000 more on this engine. So just a quick, easy way to get a vague idea of the lifespan you've got on your chain and what you may need in the future. So the turbo cars use a oil pressure ratcheting tensioner, so the chain is going to be tight. It's always going to be held tight. The non-turbo cars use a spring, so it doesn't ratchet and extend, so the chain could be a little loose sometimes, but doesn't necessarily mean there's anything wrong with it, because as soon as the car is started, the pressure is there and it pumps that tensioner up. The real check to measure if there's something going wrong with your chain is, has it elongated? So pop your valve cover off. As you can see, it only took a couple minutes for me to do this, and now I can put the valve cover back on and drive with an eased mind, knowing that my chain has plenty of life left. Thanks for watching.